All right, so here we go, part two of restoring this Les Paul. I get some zip strip and I'm going to test a little piece here on the back of the Les Paul. I want to see how easily it comes off. Instructions are to brush it on, wait 20 minutes, and then start to scrape it off. So then we let it sit about 20 minutes. I'm going to get my scraper and just wanted to see how it came off. Comes off pretty nicely. I didn't put too thick of a coat on. Just really wanted to see how it scrapes off, what the feel like is before I put my gloves on and, really slather this all over the body. So here I got a pair of gloves on. Gonna speed up the video here a little bit. This video gets a lot messy and it's pretty long in the sense that this probably took me 2 hours to get the body clean, a lot longer than I originally had thought. And at one point, you'll see after I use all the stripper, it's just a complete mess. So, we'll get the stripper all over the body here about 20 minutes later. We're going to start to go ahead and scrape it off, and you can see this comes off and just a bunch of large chunks. And so the more you put on, the easier this is going to come off. In a couple strokes here, I've got most of the finish off in terms of the large, thick pieces. You can see what a big mess this is. So I put another coat on. So here I want to really get down to some of the bare wood. So I throw on another coat and then begin to scrape it off as well. And you can see I'm actually getting down to some of the bare wood now. There's really not much of a mess here, and this is really just kind of scraping up and dumping all of this into the control cavity. Then I've got a wet cloth. It says to clean up with, a wet cloth, and here I'm just kind of scraping off any residue. So next then we'll move to the top. And I know this is going to ruin the binding, but the binding is pretty trash, so at this point I just want to get the finish off. So we'll put this all over the top. And again, you can see it just comes off real simple. There I was actually just playing with it and it all came off, so put my gloves on, get a container to throw this stuff into. And there you go, pretty much the finish came off real quick. This is really as simple as brushing it on and then scraping it off. But you can see all the residue left everywhere, and you got to go back and forth a number of times to get it right. So then we'll move to the neck. Neck is definitely a little bit tricky because of all the different curves. It's not like you could just do one pass and it all comes off. You got to kind of scrape in multiple times. I masked off the fretboard where I'm going to glue it on and the headstock. So I want to save the headstock. I want to keep that the same. You can see how much more effort there is with the headstock and the neck. Just got to start scraping everywhere. So the neck heel, the neck joint, and the top of the neck are definitely a lot of work. Lots of maneuvering the scraper and the guitar body to get it clean. You can see where I masked off the fretboard, where I'm going to glue it on. I don't want that residue. So in here, we're going to start the sides. I would definitely recommend the thicker pair of gloves. The lighter nitrate Costco type of gloves weren't all that great. So I went this with this thicker pair. So again, just cleaning up all the different nooks and crannies of the guitar body to get this finish off. So again, put the stripper on, wait about 20 minutes, and then come back and scrape it. So at this point, you can see the guitar body is pretty messy. And if you've never done this before, you're going to freak out when you're done because it looks terrible. So you gotta buy the strip cleaner product, and then this is the afterwash of stripping. And what this is essentially like a liquid stripper, and it's going to help clean up all the mess. So here I take this back to the top, and you just start rubbing it in, and it starts pulling off all that residue from the guitar body. And this is really a great product. You can see the whole body getting cleaned up on the top here. You have to use a decent amount. I actually used about half of this bottle for the guitar, but it really does a nice job. You can see that corner there just gets completely wiped out as you just scrub it. Real neat product, real great way to clean up. I think a lot of folks use the stripper and then they have this mess and like, what do I do? Like, well, you got to use the afterwash. And you could see how clean the body gets after you use that afterwash. It's pulling off all the residue, it's cleaning everything up. And the top actually is manageable at that point. So we'll do the same thing on the back and the sides here, and any of the residue, starts to come off. I would recommend getting these blue gloves, these thick blue gloves. They definitely have the right protection, and they're not going to get ruined. So these gloves are right next to the stripper and the afterwash, and these I can use forever. So here's a guitar body after it's been all cleaned up, and starting to see a lot of flaws in the body that I'll show you here in a second, but this is pretty manageable. Looks pretty good. Easy to clean up. Top's looking nice. Binding's a little bit trash, but knew that was going to happen. The binding gets melted. Here I start to see some flaws in the body, some wood chipping by the output jack and by the horn. Then I see some filler by the top of the binding there, and then just some weird glue or something laid in. So what I want to do is kind of start to prep the top, and I'm going to get some 240 grit sandpaper and just wanted to start sanding the top, make sure I get all the scratches off from scraping, a couple scratches here and there. So I want to just take the sandpaper, go back and forth and clean up the top. Again, I'm not using a power sander here because I do not want to recontour the top at all. I just want to clean up. So we'll speed up the video here as well. And really just sanding the top, getting it clean. Again, this is a lot of back and forth with the sanding, getting the body prepped. You can see the back is starting to look nice, the top looks nice, the neck's looking pretty good. Just a lot of sanding to clean this up. Surprisingly, the grain filler is still intact in some of these spots, so I'm sanding off a little bit more grain filler here as well. And I know I'm going to have to go back and use grain filler again and get the coloring right. There, I got a little notch in the neck. I started to clean up, pull that little notch off. It was a little indentation from either falling or someone stepping on it or something weird. This guitar was really not taken care of at all. So cleaning up the back of the headstock. And then I use a different palm sander, one that's got more of a grip and a flat edge to get the sides. And again, this is just going back and forth, getting this all cleaned up. One reason I did this before taking the binding off is I wanted to keep the integrity of the sand. If I have the binding off, I was thinking I might dig into the side a little bit, and I did not want to do that. I want to keep the integrity of the side. So when I get to the tight corner, I'm going to do this all by hand. Next up is we're going to use the heat gun here and pull off the binding of the top. This actually was pretty easy. I got a screwdriver, an awl, a chisel, a heat gun, all these different tools to try and just pop that binding off. And pretty simplistic. You just heat up the binding ever so slightly, take that screwdriver and kind of slowly turn it back and forth, and you get the binding kind of pop off. Binding does not come off perfectly. And so you got a couple weird spots like here where it's really stuck in there pretty well. So you're gonna have to try a couple different ways of getting that out. That's where I get my chisel. Got the heat gun right there, and just kind of pushing in and trying to loosen up that binding piece. What's nice about the heat gun is the air comes out pretty focused, and so you just keep it on that one spot and move it around. You don't want to heat up the wood too much or burn it. Keep it in one spot, you'll actually burn the wood. So what I'm doing is moving the heat gun back and forth to just heat up the binding. This little corner was definitely a pain to get pulled out. I'm just trying to use that edge of the chisel to kind of push it down and make sure it comes out clean. It's not coming out clean. So what I'm doing here is just smashing it down and trying to get a big piece, either big enough to pull like that or just move it. It's hot. Couldn't use gloves with this because I don't have the feel. But I'm moving the heat gun back and forth. So here we'll speed this up. I got the awl in there. Finally, the awl kind of popped it out. Go back to the chisel. And then boom, just keep going. The rest of the body moved really quickly. You can see just heat it up, pop it off with the chisel, and just kind of walk that chisel back and forth. As you can see, I'm kind of turning my hand, slowly pulling the binding off. So once I pull off the binding, I see a lot of weirdness in this body. Just messy all over the place. Here you can see they used some filler because there was a significant amount of runout when they actually routed for this binding channel. This edge here is rough, and I just don't understand. Look at this. This wood is actually coming apart, and this would have only really happened when they were making the body. I don't know how the previous owner would have done this, but you can see the binding channel has all sorts of runout, and they actually used filler here to kind of keep it together so it was easier to paint. You could see right there, it's just a mess. Really disappointed in Gibson here. Not sure what was going on with this body. That's another piece of filler. It's nice though, is the traditional binding and the binding they used is about the same size. So the binding channel will need to be cleaned up. And so that means I've got to pull off the neck. I'm not really wanting to do that. But I've got a drill. Going to drill four holes here. Help get the steam into the neck joint. So I've got this old Wagner steamer wallpaper remover that I'm going to repurpose. All in all, this next piece of work here takes about 50 minutes. I'm going to let the steam just sit, cover up, the pieces of the body that I don't want to get steamed. So I've got the body wrapped, I've got the neck wrapped. And this is just a lot of back and forth to get the steam going. The first 20 minutes, I'm just letting it sit, kind of heat up that joint. It's not doing the greatest job in the beginning, so you really just need to have some patience and let the steam work in there. I'm going to take the top off here. And put the steam into the pocket itself and make sure it gets into where I drilled those holes. I probably could have drilled slightly larger holes. I was using about an eighth inch bit, but I didn't want to have them too big. And the key is definitely to get down into where the channel is, where they've actually smoothed out the back of the neck to let the glue sit. So you can see the steam coming out. Just going to take this and work this all over the joint. Lots of back and forth here. Let it sit for 10 minutes. Work it around. Come back, see if the neck is loose at all. We'll go ahead and speed this up a little bit. You want to make sure you get all different sides of where that neck joint is. The wood will swell up here, but it also shrink back down once you're done. So I'm not really too worried about doing this. This is definitely more of an advanced procedure. I would not recommend folks doing this if they haven't kind of done this type of surgery before. So I've got my awl now, and I'm just kind of cleaning up the joint, kind of force that awl in and move the wood around slightly. See, get that steam in there and try and break that glue bond. Testing to see if the neck is loose at all. It's definitely not loose here. I'm gonna go back, just let this sit. So I take my razor blade, do some more scarring, see if it comes out. You can use the awl and kind of push it around. So I've also got a screwdriver pushing around, just seeing if anything's loose. And last, we're gonna create a little tent here. And here's the magic. So that was a clean takeoff. Next, what we're going to do is kind of wash off some of the glue. I got the steam handy. Glue is still wet, so I'm going to get a couple chisels, old chisels, and clean this up. Last part of the video here then is me actually clamping the neck and the body back down to something straight and dead level. You've got all that heat, all that steam. The wood is really prone to warp at this point. So I take the neck and I clamp it back down to my granite plate, and then I take my body and clamp it down and weight it down to that plate as well, and let this sit for about 4 or 5 days. Make sure all the steam comes back out and the wood is stabilized.